When you think of Japanese food, what's the first destination that comes to mind? Is it Osaka, often called Japan's kitchen? Is it Tokyo, the city with the most Michelin-starred restaurants in the world? Or is it Kyoto, the former imperial capital with a long, rich culinary history? These are all popular choices, but there is one region in Japan that you shouldn't easily dismiss when it comes to food: Kyushu Island. Japan's southernmost region has brought a lot to the nation's dining table. After all, it is here that ramen, Japan's globally celebrated comfort food, was born. And while the rest of the country doesn't have a strong street food culture, it is definitely alive and kicking in Fukuoka. Everywhere you'll find yatai or mobile food carts where locals head for after work for some good food and good time. Half of all the yatai in Japan can be found in this city alone. And that's just Fukuoka. Other prefectures have their own signature dishes, from Hita City's own take on the yakisoba to Nagasaki's foreign-influenced delicacies. Hey there, poor traveler, we are Vince and Josh. In this video, we'll show you around Kyushu Island and give you a taste of some of the food delights that you shouldn't miss in this part of Japan. But in this batch, we'll cover only those in the northern half of the island. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon so you'll get alerts when we upload new travel videos. Let's start with the most popular. The first bowl of Hakata ramen was served in the streets of Hakata's Nakasu district, which is why Fukuoka is often dubbed the birthplace of ramen. Each city in Japan has their own version of preparing ramen, but Hakata-style tonkotsu ramen is undoubtedly the most successful, spreading not just around the country, but around the globe.
So, nandito na kami sa loob ng parang factory and restaurant ng Ichiran dito sa Fukuoka.
The world-famous Ichiran, with branches even in North America, has its roots in Hakata. You'll also find widely respected ramen bars like Shinshin, Anzen Shokudo, and Ramen Kobo Ryu. And of course, it is also served at many yatai stalls throughout the city. Hakata ramen uses thin, firm noodles and is typically topped with green onions and slices of chashu pork. Its soup is tonkotsu-based, which means it uses pork bones that is boiled and simmered for many hours. While it is believed that the original tonkotsu soup started in Kurume, Hakata's take on it took it to another level. Hakata's stock is often koteri, which is rich, opaque, and sometimes frothy. It packs a punch of umami with every spoonful. At Shinshin and Hakata Iso, I noticed that it also has a very subtle bitter aftertaste, which prevents the porky flavor from being too overpowering. Another Hakata specialty is the ubiquitous Japanese dumplings, gyoza. Like gyoza in other parts of the country, Hakata gyoza are grilled or fried in cast iron pans. But what makes it different is its size. These bite-sized wonders are much smaller, but what it lacks in dimensions, it makes up for in the taste department. These small but terrible dumplings are very flavorful, and in some establishments, Hakata gyoza are served in soup. It's best enjoyed with ice-cold beer. Like Hakata ramen, Kumamoto ramen has tonkotsu-based broth, but that's when the similarities stop. Kumamoto often uses much thicker noodles than its northern neighbor. It is also usually asari, which means light and thin, most likely because most versions are blended with chicken stock. That said, despite being lighter-bodied, Kumamoto ramen packs a ton of bold flavors, thanks to the generous servings of garlic, which may come as a layer of rich mayo or burnt garlic oil, sprinkles of fried garlic chips, or both. Regardless, it is this distinctly strong garlic flavor that sets it apart from other ramen styles. I am a sucker for garlic and bold, punchful taste profiles, so Kumamoto ramen is definitely my cup of tea. So I made sure that I would be able to try it while in the city. And I can say definitively that it's one of my top 3 favorite ramen styles in Japan. While most Japanese cities take pride in their own take on the hearty ramen, Hita City has made a name for itself as a yakisoba destination. Yakisoba is a stir-fry buckwheat noodle dish which is popular throughout Japan. But here in Hita, they take yakisoba seriously. Hita yakisoba is usually fried on a very hot plate almost to a crisp, giving it that signature smoky aroma. Copious amounts of bean sprouts, onions, special soy sauce, and meat, usually pork, are added. One traditional way of cooking is jigoku mushi, which means hell steaming or cooking using the steam coming from hot springs. The salty steam is said to highlight the natural flavors of the ingredients while it retains the nutrients that would otherwise be lost through other cooking methods. At Jigoku Mushi Kobo Cooking Center, you can steam your food yourself. And all you need to do is pick your orders using a machine, hand over the tickets to the staff, and wait for the fresh and raw ingredients usually served in woven trays. Then, bring your food to a Jigoku Mushi workshop where you'll find kitchen hearths. Put your gloves on, put the food inside, and let the waiting game begin. Once cooked, don't forget to pick up your sumptuous meal out of this unique oven. Or, if you're up for some dessert, you can have a taste of strong jikoku mushi pudding or hell steamed pudding. At Myoban Onsen, you will find Okamotoya Shop, which serves their signature pudding in all its milky goodness. When it comes to Japanese wagyu, the first things that would come to mind are Kobe beef or Matsusaka beef. But Japan boasts other brands that are also celebrated for their high quality. Some of the island's signature food products are Saga beef, which comes from Japanese black cattle, and Kumamoto's Aso beef, which comes from Akaushi or Japanese brown cow or red cow. Kyushu's land may be volcanic, but its map is shaded with miles of grasslands that are ideal for grazing cattle. Like the top quality Wagyu brands, it is best known for the beautiful marbling of meat and fat, bright flavor, and tender, almost melt-in-your-mouth texture. You can enjoy it as a donburi or rice topping, or yakiniku or barbecue style. Another meat delicacy in Kumamoto is horse meat, locally called basashi. It's not clear how horse became food here, but it's usually eaten grilled like at some yakiniku places or raw, sashimi style. No one knows why it's called turkey rice or Turkish rice. There is nothing Turkish about it at all. What we know for sure is that it is a strange combination of international cultures on a plate. Pilaf rice, tonkatsu or pork cutlet, and Neapolitan spaghetti glazed with a sauce. One theory suggests that because rice comes from Asia and spaghetti comes from Italy, the place in between is Turkey, hence the name. Regardless, give it a try when you find yourself in Nagasaki. It does look like a buffet plate or a combo meal, but they somehow work together. While turkey rice is popular in Nagasaki, Saga has its own foreign-named head-scratching invention, Sicilian rice. Like turkey rice, no one has any idea why it's called such or how it is related to the Italian island halfway around the world, but it has become a regional specialty. Sicilian rice is pretty simple. Rice topped with fried meat, vegetable salad, and a sprinkle of mayonnaise. Each restaurant serving it has their own version, topping it with a more complex dressing or changing the type of meat. More upscale establishments serve it with saga beef or wild boar meat, others with regular beef or chicken. Some add other ingredients, but at its core, it's composed of rice, meat, and salad. Many cities in Japan lay claim to the origin of Japanese green tea. Uji in Kyoto and Hirado City in Nagasaki are both marketed as the birthplace of this well-loved drink, but Saga Prefecture cannot be discounted. Like the other cases, Saga's claim is rooted in Eisai, a monk credited for bringing tea leaves from China. One of the places where he is believed to have planted tea was Mount Sefuri, located in Kanzaki, Saga Prefecture. Later on, it spilled over to neighboring Ureshino, which embraced it wholeheartedly and took it to another level. Ureshino has the right conditions for growing quality tea. its landscapes are dominated by terraced countrysides covered in groves. Today, there is a strong tea culture in this part of Saga. Green tea is served in most establishments, and some even serve samplers like Kihako of Yoshidaya Cafe, which will allow you to taste three types of local green tea. Most Japanese cities take pride in their own signature versions of ramen. Here in Nagasaki, locals prefer their bowls filled with champon. Champon is a noodle soup dish. It also uses ramen or pulled noodles, but they're thicker than usual. The broth, made with pig and chicken bones, is also thicker in consistency, creamy, almost milky, but lighter in taste. Every bowl also comes with generous helpings of various vegetables and seafood, usually shrimp and squid. Other types of meat like chicken and bacon are sometimes added. Champon's origins can be traced back to a Chinese restaurant called Shikairo, which is believed to have created champon in 1899 to cater to the Chinese students looking for cheap but filling comfort food. The restaurant still operates to this day and even has an attached champon museum. You can find it near Ura Church. Many other Nagasaki specialties also feature heavy foreign influences, like Sara Udon, which are noodles fried to a crisp and then topped with vegetables like cabbage and carrots and seafood like shrimp and squid. Kakuni Manju, which are Japanese braised pork belly wrapped in soft steamed bun, and Castella cake, a type of sponge cake brought by Portuguese merchants in the 16th century when they were allowed to trade in the city. It is said to have been named after Castile, a historical region of Spain. The original recipe of the cake used only flour, eggs, starch syrup, and sugar, with no milk or baking powder. Producing one at the time was so difficult, which makes it a very special treat. Over the centuries, a lot has changed with the ingredients and the way they bake it. You'll find Castella at Japanese confectionery stores and some souvenir shops throughout Nagasaki. If you plan on visiting multiple cities or prefectures around Kyushu Island, consider purchasing a JR Kyushu Rail Pass, which comes in three variants: Northern, Southern, and All Kyushu. If the places on your itinerary are in Fukuoka, Nagasaki, Saga, and the northern halves of Kumamoto and Oita prefectures, a JR Northern Area Kyushu Pass is sufficient. It's available in 3-day and 5-day versions. A 3-day pass costs almost the same price of a round-trip Fukuoka-Nagasaki ticket, but this can also be used on all your JR train journeys within Northern Kyushu, including rides around Fukuoka. If you need more information about traveling around Japan, you'll find comprehensive travel guides with sample itineraries on our website, www.uppertraveler.net, or check out the links in the description. If you have questions, make good use of the comment section below. If you have a Spotify account or Apple Podcasts app, follow and tune in to the Poor Traveler Podcast. You can also follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Just look for @thepoortraveler. That's all for now. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.